Hello everyone, I welcome you back for this National Parks in News series. Already we covered 50 national parks which were in news in between June 2019 to April 2020. So we made that as 5 videos, so that is already available in our YouTube channel, and I have posted the link for the playlist in the description box. So please see all those 5 videos before seeing this. This is part 6 video. In this video we are going to discuss another 10 national parks. Since the prelims has been postponed to October 4, we are going to cover the national parks which were in news in May 2020, June 2020 and July 2020. So in these 3 months, we are going to cover another 10 national parks, wildlife sanctuaries and tiger reserves which were in news. So let us see the 10 protected areas of the news today. So these are all the 10 areas which we are going to cover today. So it is going to be assorted ones. Earlier, the first 50 we saw state basis, so these rest of the 10 is going to be in a assorted basis only. So this is the first national park which we are going to see. The 51st wildlife sanctuary is Dehing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary. So I said this as national park because government is going to upgrade it as national park. Assam government has decided to upgrade the Dehing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary into a national park. So why they are going to upgrade it? Because recently National Board of Wildlife, which is going to give approval for any project that has to be taken place in a protected area, has given approval for coal mining. So already this Dehing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary is a wildlife sanctuary, and there is an elephant reserve also in this. So government now has given approval for coal mining within the reserve, but the state government wants to protect this national park, protect this wildlife sanctuary. So what they have decided to upgrade it to national park. If they are upgrading a wildlife sanctuary to national park, what will happen? National park is having strict regulation with respect to protection. No outside activities is allowed, no developmental activities allowed, everything is strictly banned. But in wildlife sanctuary, everything is allowed and everything is regulated. So if you want to get anything done in a wildlife sanctuary, you have to get permission from National Board of Wildlife, and you can carry out with mining or industries. But with respect to national park, everything is strictly banned. So on this logic only, government decided to upgrade this wildlife sanctuary into national park in order to protect the pristine elephant reserve, which is located within the Dehing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary. So as an opposition to the central government's decisions. So Dehing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary is also known as Jaipur Rainforest. So this is also a rainforest. This is the only rainforest. Rainforest means which will be having dense vegetation. Let us see the characteristics of rainforest. It will be having dense vegetation. It will be having rain throughout the year. So dense vegetation and rain throughout the year and high biodiversity are the characteristics of the rainforest. The trees will be very taller also. So that is another characteristic. So it is a rainforest. So that is one thing which you have to note. Only rainforest in Assam. Dehing is the name of the river. So Dehing is a river which is flowing in that particular region, and Patka is the hill which is located in the foot of the sanctuary. So Dehing river is a left bank tributary of Brahmaputra. If you see this Brahmaputra river, Dehing is a left bank tributary of Brahmaputra. So that is one thing which you have to note, because river and tributaries are also being asked. Since this river is flowing through that area, it got its name. And Patkai Bum Hills are located as a part of the Eastern Himalaya. So that is also lies in this sanctuary. And it also consists, so this region is also highly rich in natural resources. And we all know Digboi is having the oil refinery there, that is also located there. And open cast coal mining is also located in that particular area. One thing, another thing which you have to notice, it is a tropical wet evergreen forest bordering Arunachal Pradesh. So it is a only tropical evergreen forest which is located. And I am stressing on this evergreen forest because UPSC is asking question. See, this is a question which was asked in 2018. Which of the following national parks lies completely in a temperate alpine zone? So likewise, they are giving the vegetation characteristics and asking which national park lies there. What is the characteristic? Like this, they can ask another question. Which of the following national park lies, which of the following national park is a complete wet evergreen national park in Assam? So like that, they can ask a question. So UPSC will not directly ask the question with respect to use. They will take the national parks from news and ask the question indirectly like this. So answer for this question was Valley of Flowers. So similarly, they can also ask another question. So that's why I am post upgradation, Dehing Patkai will be the 6th national park in Assam. Already we are having Kaziranga National Park, Nameri, Manas. Manas is the one which is famously bordered with Bhutan. and Dibrush Aikova. Dibrush Aikova was also news in this year because there was a wildfire in Assam. That wildfire took place in the Dibrush Aikova. So that's why it was in news. And that wildfire was mainly because of the fire in the oil refinery. So that's why it was in news. Then we are having Rajiv Gandhi Orang National Park. So apart from this, it is going to be the sixth one. So this is the map of the Deing Patkai. If you could see, this is the Patkai River, which is joining the Brahmaputra River, which is located there. This is Deing River, and it is joining the Brahmaputra here. So Deing Patkai is located here exactly. The next wildlife sanctuary in the news is Kabini Wildlife Sanctuary. We all know Kabini because we know Kabini River, which is a tributary of Kaveri. It is located in Karnataka. So Kabini Wildlife Sanctuary is another wildlife sanctuary which is in the Kaveri Basin. Recently, a black panther was spotted in the Kabini Wildlife Sanctuary. That's why it is in news. So black panther is a type of a feline animal which is located in Western Ghats. So in India, black panthers are rarely spotted. So they rarely exist, and they are pitch dark. They are pitch black. They will look like a tiger or a cheetah, but they are pitch black. That's the black panther. That's why they are called as ghosts of forest. They are rarely spotted, and whenever they are spotted, it is a thrilling experience. So that's why they are called as ghosts. They can found in Kabini Wildlife Sanctuary. Anshi Dandeli Sanctuary. Anshi Dandeli Sanctuary is in the Uttar Kannada district. We are going to see about Anshi also later. Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve, Tadoba Andari Tiger Reserve in Maharashtra. Already we discussed about Tadoba Andari in the previous video. And Netravali Wildlife Sanctuary. If you could note in news, in June 2020, again another black panther was spotted in Netravali. So within the 2 months, so this was spotted in Kabini in May, and in Netravali it was spotted in June. So back to back it is being spotted. So Netravali Wildlife Sanctuary is located in Goa. So it is also being spotted there. So that's why it is in news. Twice black panther was spotted, once in the Kabini Wildlife Sanctuary, another time in the Netravali Wildlife Sanctuary. So note down both, Netravali Wildlife Sanctuary is in Goa. So what is a black panther? Black panther, you don't think this black panther. This is a different black panther. This black panther which you are discussing is this. It look like a tiger, but it is pitch dark. See, this is a black panther which was spotted in Kabini, and this black panther was spotted in Netravali. This Kabini Wildlife Sanctuary is located as the part of the Nagarhole National Park. If you could note, this is the Nagarhole National Park, and it is part of the Nagarhole National Park. So that's why I'm showing it here. This is the zoomed image of the Western Ghats, and if you could see, Nagarhole is located exactly here. So Kabini is located in this region near the Bandipur. And Netravali, it is located here. It is in the South Goa. The third national park in news is Mount Harriet National Park. Mount Harriet National Park is having a speciality because it is located in Andaman and Nicobar Island. So it is one of the national park in the island. Recently, Pinanga Andamanensis. Recently, Pinanga Andamanensis is a plant. It is a palm variety. It is a rare plant. It is an endemic plant to Andaman. And that plant is located only in this Mount Harriet. But what happened? Recently, the scientists from Jawaharlal Nehru Tropical Botanical Garden Research Institute, so JNTBGRI, which is located in Trivandrum, they cultivated this particular palm, which is located exclusively in Andaman and Nicobar Island in Trivandrum. So they cultivated this plant, which was endemic to Andaman in Trivandrum. So that's why it is in news. So now the next question arises, why it was cultivated by this Tropical Botanic Garden Research Institute? Because it is a critically endangered species. It is a palm variety which looks like an areca nut, which is also known as Kottapakku. So this areca nut kind of a species, it is a critically endangered species. So why it became critically endangered? Because this plant variety is favored for the elephants located in the Andaman. These elephants which are located in Andaman used to graze on them. They are eating away all the species there. That's why the population of this particular plant variety is falling in Andaman and Nicobar Island. It is one unique variety which is located only there. So in order to protect that, the government of India decided to translocate it. They decided to take the germplasm there, and they brought it to Trivandrum and they cultivated it, so that we have to preserve the germplasm of that particular species. If you are leaving it in Andaman, one day it might go extinct because of overconsumption of elephant or because if there is any other natural disaster. So that is the reason why we wanted to cultivate it in Kerala. So it is a rare palm endemic to South Andaman Island. Its entire population, only some 600 plants are left. Only some 600 palms are only left now. So it might get endangered any time recently. So it is located in Mount Harriet National Park. This national park is also having a hill. It is the third highest peak in Andaman. In Andaman and Nicobar Island, Saddle Peak is the tallest peak, followed by Saddle. It is Mount Thuillier. After this Mount Thuillier, Mount Harriet is the third largest peak in Andaman. This peak, it is covered with the evergreen forest. Again, note down the type of the forest. So this is that Pinanga Andamanensis. So this is the palm tree which is getting endangered there. An elephant used to eat it. And if you could see, this is the 20 rupees notes, and this particular view which is there in the old 20 rupees note. So this is actually a picture taken in the Mount Harriet National Park. That's an additional fact which I wanted to add. So this is that national park. So why this question is important? Because UPSC is asking such question. Recently our scientists have discovered new distinct species of banana. They found a new distinct species of banana. In which state it is located, they asked. So it is Andaman Island. So where it was founded, they asked. Similarly, they can ask. Recently our scientists have cultivated a palm which is Trivandrum, which is successfully grown in which of the following national park, they can ask, or which of the following region they can ask. So whenever scientists do or research something new, it is always asked by UPSC. So it was asked in 2016. So similarly, a question can also be asked this year. That's why I'm discussing this national park. Okay. So this is the map here. If you could see, it is located in South Andaman. So this is North Andaman. This is South Andaman. So it is located in the parts of the South Andaman. So this is Little Andaman. So we should know the names of the islands distinctively. So it is located in South Andaman. This is Car Nicobar. This is Greater Nicobar. So likewise, we have to know the names. So the fourth national park in news is Bitharganika National Park. Bitharganika National Park is in Odisha. Odisha government has started a 2-year conservation program for fishing cats protection. So fishing cat protection is being planned to be conserved in the Bitharganika National Park, and that's why it is in news. So fishing cat was also announced by government of India recently. After they released the tiger census, they also announced that they will be protecting these fishing cats in India. So that's why this fishing cat is in news for various reasons, and it is also located in Bitharganika National Park. Fishing cats are nocturnal animals. They are active in nights, so they hunt only in the nights. Apart from fish, they also prey on frogs, crustaceans, snakes, birds, etc. They are located mainly in the mangrove forest. So that is another thing which we have to note. They are located in mangrove forest of Sundarbans. We all know Bitharganika National Park is also a mangrove forest. So generally they are grown in mangrove forest, foothills of Himalayas, and then in Western Ghats. In all the three locations it is located. Habitat of species is very important to note. So the protection status of this fishing cat is that in IUCN list it is vulnerable. So you have to note, see, the palm species which we saw earlier was critically endangered, and this is vulnerable. So in appendix 2 of sites, and it is in schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act. Since it is in schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act, it is accorded the highest levels of protection. So this is the fishing cat. If you could see, this fishing cat is searching for fish in a mangrove ecosystem. This is the map of our Bitharganika National Park. So Bitharganika National Park is located in the Kendrapara district of Odisha. So it is exactly located here. So this is where we are having Bitharganika National Park, and we know this is the Gahirmata Marine Sanctuary. We already discussed about this Gahirmata Marine Sanctuary in the earlier video. So it is in the northern part of Gahirmata Marine Sanctuary. So this national park is located in the Kendrapara district of Odisha. So it is also a Ramsar site. So that is another additional information which you have to note. It is a Ramsar site. It is the second largest mangrove ecosystem in India after Sundarbans. And another important trivia is rivers flowing through it. So already in 2014 UPSC asked this question, that is national park and rivers flowing through it. So in that model they can ask again. So national park and wildlife sanctuary is inundated by Brahmini river. So Brahmini river, this is Brahmini river, this is Baitarini river, and this is Dhamra. So all the three rivers are moving through it. So Bhamini, Baitarini and Dhamra. So note down the rivers. So this is the exact location. So the fifth national park for the day is Namdapa National Park. Namdapa National Park is located in the Arunachal Pradesh. So it is located in the Arunachal Pradesh state. It is in news because of the discovery of two new butterfly species in the Arunachal Pradesh. Lepidopterists are those people who study about the butterfly. So it is Lepidopterists. So the two new butterfly species are striped hairstreak, which is located in the Vijayanagar region. So striped hairstreak is one species, and next one is elusive prince. This striped hairstreak is a species which is having its relationship with respect to the Tibetan butterfly species, and elusive prince is having some Vietnamese connection. So both these new species were discovered in the Vijayanagar region, which is bordering the Namdapa National Park. So that's why it was in news. So this elusive prince is also similar to the black prince, which is found in the eastern Himalayas. So that is an additional fact. So this Namdapa National Park lies in the boundary of India and Myanmar in the Changlong district of Arunachal Pradesh. Speciality of this national park is that it is having the all the four feline species, that is tiger, leopard, snow leopard, and clouded leopard. So all these four feline species are located in the same national park. So that is the speciality of this Namdafa National Park. Helok gubbins, it is a specific ape species that is also found in this particular national park. So these are all these two butterfly species. This is the striped hair streak, and this is the elusive prince which was discovered recently. If you could see the map, this is actually the Vijayanagara region. So this is Vijayanagara region. On all the three sides of Vijayanagara region is Myanmar, and one side it is surrounded by Namdafa National Park. Everything is under Namdafa National Park. Here only we found this new butterfly species. We are having this Dehing Patkai Wildlife Sanctuary here, which we saw recently, which we saw previously in the video. So that is located here, and this is located nearby to this particular national park. So that is why it is in news. So the next national park in news is Toranklang Wildlife Sanctuary. Toranklang Wildlife Sanctuary is located in the Mizoram. So recently, Government of India, Ministry of Agriculture launched a new project called Green AG Project. So Green Agriculture Project, which aims at reducing the emissions from agriculture. And agriculture is one area where a lot of greenhouse gases are emitted because of the rice cultivation, especially it emits the methane. And also it ensures at sustainable agricultural practices. So this project aims at bringing almost 1 lakh hectares of farm under sustainable land and water management. So that is the main aim. So it also aims at sequestering 49 million carbon dioxide equivalent. See, in the Paris Agreement in INDC, we have accepted that we will be sequestering 3 billion CO2 equivalent of carbon dioxide from atmosphere. That is, we'll be absorbing 3 billion tons equivalent of carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. This will help at achieving that target. So that is, we are going to sequester 49 million carbon dioxide equivalent through this project. So this project aims to complete the target between March 2026. So a pilot project was launched in 35 villages and 2 protected areas within the Mizoram. So that 2 protected areas are Dampa Tiger Reserve and Toranklang Wildlife Sanctuary. So these are all the 2 protected areas where the project was launched. That's why this is in news. That's why Toranklang is in news. It is launched jointly by Ministry of Agriculture along with the Global Environment Facility. So Global Environment Facility plus Ministry of Agriculture have jointly launched the project. And also Ministry of Environment and Food and Agricultural Organization. These 2 organizations are also collaborating in this project. So this is the map of Mizoram. If you could see, this is actually the Mizoram map. In Mizoram, this is the Dampa Tiger Reserve, and this is Lunglei. In this Lunglei district only, we are having this Toranklang Wildlife Sanctuary. So these are all the 2 areas in Mizoram where the project is being launched. So the next protected area in news is Melghat Tiger Reserve. This Melghat Tiger Reserve is a protected area which is located in the Maharashtra. So it is actually located in the Maharashtra-Madhya Pradesh border. So recently, Chief Minister of Maharashtra objected a Railway Ministry's project of Akola-Khandwa Railway Line. This Akola-Khandwa Railway Line connects the Akola in Madhya Pradesh, Akola in Maharashtra, and Khandwa in Madhya Pradesh. So this railway line passes through this Melghat Tiger Reserve. Since it is passing through the Melghat Tiger Reserve, it will be encroaching the tiger reserve and it will be destroying the tiger habitat. So that's why the government of Maharashtra has objected to it. Already we saw a road project is passing through Katepurna. In the previous video, we saw that a road project is passing through Katepurna Black Buck Sanctuary, which we discussed earlier. The road is Mumbai-Nagpur Highway Project. That's why Maharashtra wasn't already in news. And now another railway project is going through this Melghat Tiger Reserve, and that's why it is in news. It is located in the Amaravati district of Maharashtra. So it is enclosed by Tapi River in the north and Gavilghat Ridge of Satpura Mountains in the south. So we are having Gavilghat Ridge here, and Tapi River flows through like this, and there is another river called Purna River which joins Tapi here, and Tapi goes like this. Gavilghat Ridge is located here and Tapi River is here, and this Melghat is located in between. So that is the exact location of this particular tiger reserve. Note it down for UPSC can ask questions with regarding to tiger reserves and the rivers. So that's why note it down, the Tapi River. So it was declared as a tiger reserve in 1974. It is one of the first 9 tiger reserve which was notified under the Project Tiger. It is one of the first tiger reserve of Maharashtra. And recently, so forest owlet is a species which was considered to be extinct, and it was spotted in this particular protected area. So that's why it was in news. So this is the Maharashtra map, and if you could see, Mehelgarh Tiger Reserve is located exactly in the north in the Madhya Pradesh border. If you could zoom in, so this is where we come. So this is Akola in Maharashtra and Khandwa in Madhya Pradesh, and this road is passing through Mehelgarh Tiger Reserve here. So since it is passing through the Mehelgarh Tiger Reserve here, people are telling the concerns that it may affect the habitats of tiger here. So there is another wildlife sanctuary called Ewal Wildlife Sanctuary in the Madhya Pradesh border. So note it down. So if you could see, note it closely, this is where the river Tapi flows, and this is the Gawaligar range. So in this region only we are having this Mehelgarh Tiger Reserve. So the next is Sariska Tiger Reserve. Sariska Tiger Reserve is a tiger reserve which is located in the Rajasthan. So Ministry of Tourism conducts a convention called Dekho Apna Desh. So it is a convention, and usually there would be a lot of exhibition. In this Dekho Apna Desh, Ministry of Tourism will identify the lesser known destinations of tourism which are having high tourism potential, but it is lesser known to the people. They will identify such tourist areas, and they will be creating an exhibition to create awareness about that area to the entire world. So they will give a platform for the awareness. So like that, you can convert the lesser known tourism destination to the popular ones and improve the tourism. So that is the aim of this Dekho Apna Desh. And Dekho Apna Desh means see our country. So that is the translation. 13th session of Ministry of Tourism's webinar called Dekho Apna Desh. So because of this COVID, this convention also was converted into a webinar. It was titled Destination Sariska Tiger Reserve. So now they are identified the Sariska Tiger Reserve to be projected as the popular tourism spot of ecotourism. This Sariska Tiger Reserve is located in the Aravalli Hills. So note down the hills where it is located also. UPSC can ask like that also. Protected areas and hills. Like that also they can ask, because already they have asked with respect to the pilgrimage cities and the hills in which it is located. So on the similar lines they can ask this also. So it is located in the Aravalli Hills of Alwar district. It consists of this animals like leopard, nilgai, sambar and chital. This sanctuary is also having many forts within it. One such fort is Kankarwadi Fort. This Kankarwadi Fort is having a link with respect to medieval India with a specific event. When the Shah Jahan was getting old, there was a succession war between the two sons of Shah Jahan, that is Aurangzeb and Dara Shikoh. Eventually Aurangzeb won the war and he arrested Dara Shikoh, and the Dara Shikoh was imprisoned in this particular fort. So that is this Kankarwadi Fort. So there is a medieval India linkage to this Sariska also. This particular fort is located within the Sariska Tiger Reserve. So there can be a question with respect to medieval India also from this Sariska Tiger Reserve. So that is the one thing. It is also having rich copper reserve. See, already we saw that the Deking Bhatkai Wildlife Sanctuary is having rich oil and coal deposits. So this is having rich copper deposits, and marble mining is also prevalent there. But the Supreme Court in 1991 banned the marble mining. Irrespective of that ban, still the marble mining and the copper mining is going on in the Sariska. So that is the problem that is affecting the environment of the Sariska Tiger Reserve. So this is the map of Rajasthan. So Sariska Tiger Reserve is located in the Alwar district, exactly in the northeastern part. And we know we are having the Aravalli Hills like this. We already discussed the Keoladio, Ranthambore and Tal Chapar in the previous video. So please see those things also. The next thing which we are going to discuss is Gangotri National Park. So this Gangotri National Park is one famous national park because it is having one of the famous Gangotri Glacier within this. From this Gangotri Glacier only the river Bhagirathi originates. We all know the river Bhagirathi originates here. When it joins another river called Alaknanda in Devaprayag, it is converted into Ganga. So Ganga is officially considered to be originating from this Gangotri Glacier, and that glacier is located within this Gangotri National Park. So that is the speciality of this national park. This national park was in news because, see, this is the map here, and Gangotri National Park is located here. If you could see, there is this NH-108 which is connecting the Gangotri National Park, and government has decided to extend this road in order to connect it to China border. Because of this recent LAC crisis, and the government wants to improve the border road infrastructure and wanted to reach the borders quickly, so they are constructing a road to connect to the China border. So that road is passing through this Gangotri National Park, and that might create the habitat loss, but still government has given the approval because it is a strategic project. Recently also government launched this environment impact assessment draft notification, so which is not yet finalized. That notification says that whenever a government is having a strategic project, if it tagging that project as a strategic means, then no environment impact assessment is not needed for that particular project. So now this will be a strategic project because it will be connecting the border. Even though it is passing through the national park, no EIA will be conducted now. If this new draft EIA notification is accepted. So recently, Uttarakhand State Wildlife Authority has permitted the proposal for transfer of land for the construction of road because of the India-China border dispute. Gangotri National Park is located within the very closer to the China border, and it was declared as the national park in 1989. It is situated in the Uttarkashi district of Uttarakhand. So it is also having the catchment area of Bhagirathi River. So Gamukh is the place which is located within this Gangotri National Park, from where the river Ganga originates. So note down this word, Gamukh. The park is viable continuity. So it is acting as a continuity between two other national parks, that is Govind National Park and Kedarnath Wildlife Sanctuary. If you could see in the map here, so this is the zoomed map. This is Govind Pashu National Park and this is Kedarnath Wildlife Sanctuary, and between these two only we are having this Gangotri National Park. From this Gangotri National Park only, this Bhagirathi River is originating, and there is a road there. That road is constructed along the river only. It is coming like this. So this river will come to Devaprayag like this. There is another river called Alaknanda. This Alaknanda also originates here and comes and meets at Devaprayag. From here only this river is called as Ganga. And here we are having the Gangotri National Park between the Govind Pashu and Kedarnath. The last protected area for the news is Kali Tiger Reserve. This Kali Tiger Reserve is located in the Uttar Kannada district of Karnataka. Recently, government railways announced this Hubali-Ankola railway project connecting the Hubali within the Karnataka with the coastal town called Ankola in order to improve the connectivity with the Arabian Sea and the newly announced port. This railway project is being objected by the members of Karnataka State Wildlife Board because it will be passing through this Kali Tiger Reserve and it will be creating a habitat destruction for tigers. So that's why it is being opposed. The proposed 164-kilometer railway line passes through the forest called Kali Tiger Reserve and Betti Conservation Reserve. More than 80% of the line passes through the dense forest. So that's why the issue is dense forest of Western Ghats. Almost 727 hectares of forest will be diverted. So this Kali Tiger Reserve primarily consists of moist deciduous forest and semi-evergreen forest. So please note down the type of the forest within this Tiger Reserve. It is also having other species like leopard, elephant, bison, etc. So this points doesn't have any importance, but you have to note the type of forest and the tiger reserve and in which state it is located. So this is the actual map which is given. If you could see, there is an already existing railway route connecting Hubali to Marmagowa. So this route is transporting the goods to the Marmagowa port, which is a major international port. Now they have planned to construct this Tadri port. If they are constructing this Tadri port, they need to connect it with the Hubali town. So for that only we need a new railway line. This railway line is passing through Kali Tiger Reserve, which may cause the damage. So that is what in news. So thank you everyone. We have come to the end of the video. In today's video, we discussed 10 more national parks in the part 6 of the national park series. Totally, we have discussed 60 national parks, which was in news from June 2019 to July 2020. So almost we covered 13 months and we covered 60 national parks, wildlife sanctuaries and tiger reserves, which may come in news. So by seeing this entire video series, I hope that we will be getting 2 to 3 questions which will gain us a mark of 4 to 6 marks. This precious 4 to 6 marks might be guaranteed if you are seeing this video. So please see the entire video, and if you are liking the video, please share it with your friends, and if you are having any doubts, you can comment and subscribe to Kingmakers IAS Academy channel. Thank you.